A long, long time ago, in a movie studio far, far away, Star Wars was born. George Lucas's epic space opera is a tractor beam that captures the hearts of nerds everywhere. The movie helped launch the big budget blockbuster genre, and as far as fiction goes, it hits all the right notes. But what about the science? Some of Star Wars is actually plausible.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
And then there's some stuff which, well, yeah, not so much. I'll just get this out of the way right now. There's a few things I'm not going to cover, like did Han shoot first?
He did.
Or did Han know what a parsec is?
He doesn't.
Or midichlorians. Actually, we're going to steer clear of the prequels altogether. Sorry, Jar Jar.
The ability to speak does not make you intelligent.
From a technological perspective, the Death Star is maybe Star Wars' most impressive achievement. Except for the ductwork. What were the Imperial engineers thinking? Anyway, the Death Star has a laser that can help blow up a planet. For more on that, here's our resident Sith chemist and Star Wars buff, Rachel.
Lasers amplify light produced by energetically exciting a gas or a crystal, or sometimes using a chemical reaction. The electromagnetic radiation produced is highly coherent, meaning all the waves of light line up together, producing a very concentrated beam of energy.
We don't have lasers quite that powerful yet, but the principle is the same. The most powerful laser on Earth was a 2 petawatt laser fired in Japan. But assuming Alderaan was roughly the size of Earth, the Death Star's laser would still need a million billion times more power to blow to smithereens.
Now, when producing all that energy, you'd usually make a lot of heat, like enough heat to melt the Death Star if it fired up its laser. Not sure how the Imperial engineers got around that one. But here's an even more serious problem with the Death Star's laser. Remember how it starts with all 8 beams converging? Yeah, light doesn't do that. The individual beams would just pass through each other and keep going in their own directions.
Up next, lightsabers.
Their blades are made of plasma, which is a fourth state of matter. Adding heat can turn solids into liquids, liquids into gases, and gases into plasma. If you keep heating up a gas, it gains so much energy that some of the electrons break free from the atoms, creating a cloud of ions called a plasma. Because ions and electrons are charged, plasmas can be controlled with electromagnetic forces. These forces contain and shape the plasma in the lightsaber according to Star Wars lore. Although, like the Death Star laser, there are big questions about how much heat they're putting out.
There are other ideas out there. Neil deGrasse Tyson likes the idea of using gamma rays, and a couple of physicists at Harvard and MIT actually managed to stick some photons together. So if, and that's a big if,
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
You could clump enough photons together, maybe you could build a real actual saber of light out of them. Or maybe Star Wars was just light years ahead. So now say you want to protect yourself against a laser or a lightsaber. You're in the market for a force field. Force fields, or deflector shields, are seen all over Star Wars. But they're not explained all that well. Some developments here on Earth could give clues about what might work in the real world.
One idea is a bubble of plasma that would surround a ship. It would need a physical structure like a mesh of fine wires to keep the plasma cloud in place, but it could protect against dangerous radiation during a trip to Mars, for instance, or maybe work against those blasters. Another idea, patented by defense contractor Boeing, is an active laser force field that would make a plasma to protect against the shockwave of an explosion, which can do just as much harm as shrapnel.
So that's just the science of the OG trilogy. There's a whole sequel trilogy to come. What did you see in The Force Awakens that you want to know more about? That adorable rolling droid? Let us know in the comments. Also, it's that gift-giving season again. As you may know, we have some infographics for sale at the ACS store. Be sure to click on the link in the description to get a poster for your chemistry-loving loved ones. And hey, thanks for watching.